Hey everybody, it's Rebecca with Revenue, and it is our last episode of the Revenue Rundown for 2021. You know, since January, we've been coming at you, well, twice a month to bring you information about taxes, water bills, payment agreements, whatever we thought was important to let you know. You know, we know that the pandemic has forced Philadelphia to adjust to a lot of different procedures and policies, especially from revenue. So we're hopeful that our little videos help you navigate this, what is already like a really crazy time. So our last show is with Shruti Arvind, and it's all about a great homeowner tax assistance program that we run here at Revenue. Hey, Shruti.
Hey, Rebecca. Thanks. I'm happy to be here.
Oh, great. I'm glad that you are here. So I know that this is our last episode. We mentioned it in our last episode, but I just want to mention it here again before we get started that people now have until May 17th to pay the Philadelphia Business Income and Receipts Tax, the Net Profits Tax, the Earnings Tax, and School Income Tax without interest or penalty. We have a full blog post about those changes on our website, and we'll put a link to that in the comments. And okay, but real estate taxes were due March 31st, so that was about a week ago. So Shruti, what should a homeowner do if they missed the real estate tax due date last week?
So if a homeowner missed the real estate tax due date last week, they should try and pay as soon as possible. The fastest and easiest way for a homeowner to pay their real estate tax is online through www.phila.gov/pay. E-check is always free. If a taxpayer can't pay online, we also accept payments over the phone, by email, and in person at the Municipal Services Building. Now, to pay in person, a taxpayer does need to schedule an appointment ahead of time. If a homeowner can't pay their taxes for whatever reason, they can always apply for an owner-occupied payment agreement or an OOPA. This program allows folks to make affordable monthly payments towards their property taxes, and it's based on a family's income. I do want to point out that there is no down payment to apply for this program.
Oh, that's good. No down payment. One thing that I do want to mention is that if you come to us in the Municipal Services Building in Center City and you don't have an appointment, we do have a drop box, and we will timestamp your envelope, and you can put your payment in a drop box if that makes you feel more comfortable. You can schedule an appointment by going to our website, phila.gov/revenue, and that has more instructions. And we'll also put a phone number that you can call in the comments of this video if you need to come in person. But of course, we really encourage you to pay online or over the phone. So, okay, but getting back to an OOPA though, it's really important. It's worth mentioning the name again. It's an owner-occupied payment agreement. Because that name is kind of long, you'll hear us say OOPA all the time. In my head, it's super OOPA, but that's not here nor there. Shruti, can anyone in Philadelphia get an OOPA?
So anyone who is a property owner and who lives in the property can get an OOPA. You cannot be excluded from the agreement because you make too much or too little money. To determine the amount of monthly payments, as well as things like how much interest and penalties will abate and whether new property taxes will be included in an agreement, we will look at your family's household size as well as your family's monthly income. For some low-income seniors, we will also take age into account.
Right, and so to summarize, OOPAs are for property owners who live in their property. It's for residential, it's for homes, owner-occupied homes. So it's not for rentals, it's not for commercial property. We have different payment agreements for those situations. And then the important part is that those terms of that payment agreement are based on your income and family size, and you can never make too much money to qualify. Everyone qualifies, there's not an age qualification. It's just kind of where you fit in the terms. So what happens, Shruti, once you're in an OOPA, once you have an agreement?
So once you're enrolled in an agreement, you have to basically make your monthly payments until the end of your agreement. What you will receive is a bill each month that you can pay online, by mail, in person, or even over the phone. To stay in your payment agreement, you must pay all new property taxes as they become due. However, some low-income homeowners are able to roll new property taxes into their existing agreements.
Okay, that seems like kind of a big deal. I think it's also really, really important to mention right now that there are some low-income homeowners who would qualify for a $0 a month payment agreement. Like, if this was a different kind of video, there'd be like zeros and dollar signs flashing. So that means that you're not paying off your debt. And if you can't afford to pay off some of your debt, you should do that, because what happens is the debt continues to be tied to the property and there's a lien on your property. But the important part is that your home is protected from sheriff sale. So the city, you're in an agreement, you're in compliance, the city can't come after your home for sheriff sale, for non-payment of taxes. Okay, Shruti, how do you apply for an UPA?
So the easiest way to apply for an UPA is by downloading an application from our website. So that's www.phila.gov/UPA, and then emailing a completed application to revenue.payment.agreement@phila.gov. I want to point out that the application is available in Spanish and Chinese as well, if you prefer to fill it up in either of those languages. The application
Wait, you have to apply. You have to fill the application out in English, but it is in Spanish.
Yes, yes.
Right, okay.
The application is also a fillable form. You do not have to download it. You know, you can sort of just download it onto your desktop and then fill it up online. If you do want to take a printout, you can print out a copy and then either email us back a completed form or send it back to us by mail to P.O. Box 53250. As always, you can always call or email us if you have any questions, and we're happy to help.
Right. And the full address, if you're going to put it in the mail, is on the application. Mm-hmm. I mean, the application is pretty easy. It's like, well, pretty easy to understand. We redesigned it. Shruti and I worked on redesigning it, so I'm pretty proud of that. But Shruti, I do want to mention one thing. I noticed at the bottom of the application, there's this like checkbox that says, "I am interested in a housing counselor." What is that? What does that mean for taxpayers?
Sure. So this is also something that we added in when we redesigned the application. But you can ask to speak to a housing counselor when you fill up an UPA application. And by requesting a housing counselor, you're not only receiving help with an UPA, but that they can also help you apply for other city programs. What happens is that your application is put on hold because the housing counselor, with the anticipation that the housing counselor will reach out to you and try and help you figure out sort of the best course of action for your own situation, your own property.
Right. So your application is put on hold, but you will be working with a third party nonprofit mm-hmm. who works with the city and supports taxpayers in making the right choices for them if they're not quite sure what they want to do or maybe what their options are. Again, you can always call or email us if you have any questions, and we're happy to help. The phone number is 215-686-6442. And again, the email and the full PO box we'll put in the comments, but it's also on the application itself. And that's it. That's a wrap. That's the end of the revenue rundown for this season. I want to thank you all for joining us. We're sorry we couldn't do the revenue rundown live in 2021. Things may look different this year, but the Department of Revenue is still working really, really hard to best serve Philadelphia, and part of that means keeping you, the taxpayer, and our employees safe. If you want to get regular updates, please sign up for our email newsletter. We send those out only important information that we think folks need to know. We will add that link in the comments, but you can find it on the top of our contact page at phila.gov/revenue. And please, please, please like and share this video. Especially, you know, we know that folks have struggled in the past year. UPA is a great program for folks who maybe just find themselves in a different situation than they have in the past, and they just might not be aware of that this program even exists. I'm talking about your neighbors, or your family, or even folks who may be not online. Just let them know that there is something out there that will help protect their house. If you own and live in your home, there is no reason for you to not be in agreement if you can't pay your taxes. I want to thank you, Shruti, for joining us.
Thank you so much, Rebecca.
Great, and we'll see you next year for sure. But maybe we'll pop in. Maybe we'll do some pop-up stuff later in the year when it's a little safer. But thank you very much. Have a great rest of the day. It's nice. Get outside.